kid.
What'll it be? It's a good question to be asking right about now. What'll it be, the chair or a bullet to the head? About the only two ways out of the bind I'm in. I've got a short time left, so I'm gonna tell you what I know. This world's rotten through its core. Justice is a real pill to swallow once you realize there is no such thing. You live your life in total bliss, ignorant to the fact that it can change at any moment. Till it happens to you, till you're down in the dumps, till just dumb luck takes all you got, leaving you with nothing but the shoestring in your pocket.
Hey buddy, I don't mind if you talk to yourself all night, but you're gonna need to order something first.
Just get me a 7 and 7. I had a girl once. It was only last night that I was in this very bar watching Sue Ellen sing her number.
I can't believe that you're in love with me. For I have always placed you far above.
Do you like music?
Only when Sue Ellen sings it.
Boy, you're really in deep with her. It's okay, Casanova. I'm a girl who knows how to keep a secret. Speaking of secrets, I happen to know a thing or two about Dollface over there. Could score some big points if you stick with me, kid.
What do you know?
Mm-mm. Secrets have a price.
What do you want?
I have a favor to ask. Meet me here tonight after the bar closes, and I guarantee you'll have little Miss Sue Ellen on your hip tomorrow.
I didn't know whether to trust the dame or not. She seemed to have good intentions, and what did I have to lose? If I knew then the answer was everything, I'd have told the broad to scram.
Yeah, I'm going to pretend that didn't happen.
I'll see you tonight, babe. So what's this favor you wanted?
All I need you to do is stand there and shut up.
Hey, just what are you trying to pull, lady?
Vito, search him, get his wallet and his keys.
Unless you're hungry for a knuckle sandwich, you better back off, Buster.
You better watch who you're talking to, buddy. That's Don Patoni's son over there. And don't forget who's holding the gun here.
I woke up in a haze hours later. Vito, the big lug, was lying there next to me. It would be daylight in a few hours. I had to get out of there. I sure was in big trouble. The broad had run off with my wallet and my keys. No doubt she'd give me up to the mob and pin Vito's death on me. By that point, I knew I was a marked man. I could go to the cops, but all the evidence pointed to me. They'd never believe my story. I didn't even have a name to identify the broad that had robbed me, and by that point, she'd probably skip town. It was only a matter of time before both the cops and the mob were breathing down my neck. I got out of there as quick as I could.
I know you're probably wondering why I didn't try to run, go to Mexico or something. I knew all about the Patoni family. They've got people all over the world. They'd hunt me down and give me the axe before I even made it to the coast. I've got nowhere I can go, so I'm here. Drowning my troubles in a cold drink that might as well be my only friend in the world. Passing time as though I had any left. Well, my time's about up. The storybook's in its final chapter. I'm all washed up.
I hope you heard my story, because you might stick around long enough to see how it ends. Don't ruin the picture for me, though. I'm waiting to see whether it'll be in cuffs or looking down the barrel of a gun. Sooner or later, we'll all find out.
Thank you.